Hello, this is Peter Hollemans. I'm the primary software developer for the CoastWatch Utilities, which includes the CoastWatch Data Analysis Tool, CDAT. In the previous video, I showed how to download and install the software, and in this video, I'll show how to load a data file into CDAT, which is Chapter 3 in the User's Guide, Section 3.2. So first, where can we get data files from? I'll show a couple of options here. One of the options is the CoastWatch website for central operations, coastwatch.noaa.gov. On the data access page, you can look for directories with the name HDF. So for example, under AVHRR, level 3, HDF, there are a number of files here. Those are compatible with CDAT. And another example, let's say GOES data, HDF, these files are also compatible. You can find a description of the data products on the CoastWatch webpage under the data products page, and here's the descriptions here. So another possibility is to go to the NOAA class archive. And that's what I'm going to be doing for this demonstration. So I'm Googling for NOAA Class Archive, and here it is, www.class.noaa.gov. And what I like to do on this website is to search for AVHRR data, or the Advanced Very High Resolution Radiometer data. That's actually in a NOAA 1B format. And you can also search for CoastWatch Full Resolution swath file data in HDF format, or also the CoastWatch regions in HDF format, which is a map projection data in HDF. So for this demo, though, I'll look at the AVHRR data. And it happens that I was listening to the news at some point last year, and it was about October, late October, and I found out that on October 13th, 2013, there was an interesting hurricane that was in the region of the Western Pacific, or they call it a typhoon when it's in the Western Pacific. And so I went to the class archive and I searched for data on October 13th, and I looked for full resolution data from the MetOp A satellite, which is actually MetOp 2. And I found this data file here, second one here, and I downloaded it and I found the picture of the hurricane. So I'll use that for my demonstration. And through the magic of the class website, I was able to be notified when my data was ready, and I went and downloaded it, and I have it here. I downloaded it to my downloads directory, and the file is right here. So what I'll do is I'll go ahead and I'll start CDAT from the applications directory where I installed it, and there it is, starting up. And I could use this open button here to open the data file that I downloaded from class, and I would have to search through my file system, but I won't do that. What I like to do is I like to drag the file into CDAT, which you can do both on Mac and Windows. And so I'll do this, and it opens the file like that. And so what you can see is at the top of the window here, file information such as the satellite and the sensor, date and time, and so forth. And below that, you can see the list of 2D spatial grids that are available in that file. And in this case, it's the AVHRR instrument, and it has a number of channels that it gathers data on. And I can click on each of these items in the list to show a preview in the window beside it here. So what CDAT expects me to do is to select one or more variables from this list of variables. So I'll do that. I can either control click on Windows or command click on the Mac, or I can control A or command A to select all of the variables. I'm actually just going to select a few of them. And then I can click OK. And what it does is it scans through the data to generate some statistics and then displays the first variable. Okay, so that's downloading data from a server and loading it into CDAT. And the next video, I'll show the basic usage of CDAT. Thanks for watching.